Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.2, Problem 4. This is Section 9.2, Problem number 4. It says a random sample of 25 cars traveling on Route 24 North near Exit 5 had a sample mean speed of 68.4 miles per hour. And a sample standard deviation of 7.5 miles per hour. Construct a 95% confidence interval for the average speed of all cars on that stretch of Route 24. So, the formula that we need to use is x bar plus or minus s, the sample standard deviation, over square root of n, the sample size, times t sub c, the confidence coefficient. Now there are two formulas for confidence interval. There's really even three. Now we use this one with the s and the t sub c when we do not know the population standard deviation. We use the one with the s and the t sub c when we know the sample standard deviation, which is a more realistic situation, which is what this problem represents. We know the standard deviation only of the sample, not the entire population, not all the cars. So this is what we're going to fill in. The x bar is the sample mean, which is given in the problem as 68.4 miles per hour. So 68.4 goes in for the x bar. We have plus or minus s. The sample standard deviation is given as 7.5 miles per hour, 7.5, over square root of n. N is the size of the sample. So the size of this sample is 25. The problem tells us 25, so it'll be square root of 25. And now T sub C is the confidence coefficient. And with the t, we pull this out of the student's t distribution, which is attached at the end of this homework assignment. So for t sub c, we have to find the correct column and the correct row of that chart and see where they intersect. So the column is determined by 1 minus the level of confidence as a decimal over 2. That's how we determine the column of the chart that we're going to look in. So for this problem, 1 minus the confidence as a decimal would be 1 minus 0.95. And again, that's going to be over 2. 1 minus 0.95 is 0.05. And again, when we divide that by 2, we get 0.025. That's the column of the t-distribution we want to look in. Now for the row, the row is determined by the size of the sample. The row is one less than the sample size. It'll be labeled DF, or degrees of freedom. The degrees of freedom are one less than the size of the sample. So if our size of sample is 25, our degrees of freedom would be 24, one less than the 25. And we want to see where the 0.025 column would intersect with the 24 row. And the point at which they intersect would be 2.064. That's the value for the confidence coefficient in our formula. Now that it's filled in, we have to do the math. And again, typically if you make a mistake with one of these confidence interval problems, the mistake occurs as you fill in the formula. Once you get it filled in, if you use your calculator, most likely you'll get the right answer. So as we do the math, the first thing we must address is the square root. We have to deal with the square root first. So let's take care of that. So we'll have 68.4 plus or minus 7.5 over the square root of 25 is 5, because 5 times 5 is 25. And I'll leave the 2.064 in the end for another minute. So the next thing I can do is divide 7.5 divide by 5. So I have 68.4 plus or minus 7.5 divide by 5 is 1.5. And you can do that on your calculator if you like. I can divide it. I know that 75 over 5 is 15, and I just put the decimal back. But if you're not comfortable doing tricks like that, just take a second on your calculator, do 7.5 divided by 5 equals, and the calculator will tell you it's 1.5. And I'll bring in the 2.064. Now at this point, to finish off our margin of error, our value after the plus and minus, I can multiply 1.5 times 2.064. And that will give me 68.4 plus or minus. 1.5 times 2.064 is 3.096. So now that I have one number value after the plus and minus, I can split the confidence interval into a separate plus and a separate minus for the low end and high end of the interval. So the low end of the interval will come from 68.4 minus 3.096 to the upper end of the confidence interval will be 68.4 plus 3.096. So on the smaller end, when I do 68.4 minus 3.096, that comes out to 65.304. And when I do the upper end, 68.4 plus 3.096, it'll be 71.496. So one extra decimal there, 65.304 is the low end. So what that means is you are 95% sure that this is an interval that would contain the real population mean if you could examine all the cars that travel on Route 24 in that particular area.